Hello, my name is Bob Mixa. Welcome to the Licensing Expert Series course on Microsoft Volume Licensing Programs Fundamentals. Organizations today are facing new realities about how they operate. You will be faced with meeting today's demands while predicting tomorrow's, and all within a fixed budget. This course is designed to provide you with a clear explanation of the basics of licensing and to clarify the various ways you can acquire licenses for Microsoft software and services to help you choose the right licensing for your company's needs, all while balancing your bottom line. Let's review our agenda. We will begin by looking at transformational IT trends that are occurring and will identify some of the challenges that today's organizations face in light of these trends. We will then review licensing basic with Microsoft's volume licensing programs to help identify which programs best fit organizations based on their particular needs. We'll then look at enrollments, including the new server and cloud enrollment available only through the Enterprise Agreement, or EA. And we'll also look at the availability of Office 365 cloud services through the EA and open programs. We will also touch on the benefits of software assurance and the ways customers can take advantage of Microsoft's payment solutions, which are designed to help qualified customers manage their cash flow more strategically. We will then review several customer scenarios, after which you will be afforded the opportunity to evaluate your knowledge through an assessment. Organizations today are facing new realities about how they operate based on trends, which include cloud computing, the consumerization of IT, the explosion of data, and the development of new social and app patterns. Let's take a closer look at each of these trends. First of all, companies are moving their workloads to the cloud at an ever-increasing pace. Cloud services offer a variety of software to help organizations work effectively, from office productivity like Office 365 to device management through Windows Intune. It's predicted that by 2016, cloud-hosted workloads will be five times what they are today, which equates to two-thirds of all workloads. Secondly, applications are rapidly being developed, and these too are cloud-enabled. Today, there are 1 billion Facebook accounts, 200 million Twitter accounts producing 400 million tweets a day, 10.4 million Pinterest accounts, and 160 million LinkedIn accounts. Then we have users that are bringing devices from home to work, and these users need IT support like corporate security. And compliance needs can't be sacrificed to meet these expectations. By 2014, it's projected that there will be 3.3 devices per worker. This has led to an explosion in social experiences, in how we collaborate at work, whether in the office, at home, or mobile. This explosion is being powered by cloud services, which allow information to roam with us across devices. And as storage and data collection becomes less expensive, more data is being collected, with an increasing amount of it being streamed with the expectation that the data provides real-time analysis. Big data refers to the increasing volume, variety, and velocity of data, and industry analysts estimate that the amount of data will increase by 44 times in the next decade. And surprisingly, analysis indicates that 90% of the world's data has been created in the last 2 years. With these trends and ensuing transformations underway, the traditional approaches to IT are no longer adequate, and organizations need a different approach, to acquiring software and services that support these trends. And companies today need a unified strategy, a consistent platform, and consistent licensing that helps them navigate these trends. By delivering global scale services, Microsoft has been learning what is required from this new era of IT and has taken what has been learned together with the trends and technology innovations and built them into products and licensing to deliver and manage the modern platform, the cloud OS, or operating systems. So to enable the modern platform, the cloud OS, organizations need licensing that is flexible, simplified, and cloud-enabled. And Microsoft provides volume licensing programs tailored to meet the needs of today's organization. Let's take a closer look at Microsoft's volume licensing programs now. Let's begin by first reviewing some licensing basics. When you acquire a software license, you purchase the right to use the software. Microsoft offers different license agreements and options based on a customer's needs. These options include single licenses for a single installation and volume licensing programs, which provide significant cost savings to customers who acquire many installations of the same program. For example, installing Microsoft Office on 300 PCs. By learning about Microsoft licensing options, you can determine the best, most cost-efficient way to obtain licensed software for your particular organization's needs. A license is required for the operating system software of PCs, for applications on those devices, for server applications, and for users or devices that access the software on the server. A user client access license, called a CAL, permits the licensed user or device to access the server software. External connectors are licenses required for non-employee uses or devices accessing the server. Ways to purchase a software license. There are four key ways to buy a Microsoft license depending on the volume of licenses needed for your organizations today and in the future. The full package product, or FPP, is purchased from retailers. Typically, one box equals one license. With the OEM, or Original Equipment Manufacturer license, the license comes pre-installed on a new computer and the software is associated with the device. Volume licensing agreements are purchased directly from Microsoft or through resellers, and there are a variety of agreements to suit different types of organizations. Online services or cloud services are hosted solutions available from service providers such as Microsoft Online Services. How the products may be used are outlined in product use rights, which vary by product, product version, and by channel through which the license is acquired. Let's look at these in a little bit more detail. With full package product, the media is included in the package, as is some support. But the FPP can be expensive and only allows use of the purchased version. Additionally, license management can be cumbersome, which owners have to keep original documentation to demonstrate ownership. This is an agreement with Microsoft for Microsoft software, and use rights are documented in the retail license terms. OEM software comes pre-installed on a new computer or device, usually provides a great value. The OEM or system builder provides support, but the pre-installed license is not transferable and comes with limited downgrade rights. The hardware owner must maintain the appropriate documentation as well, which can be challenging to manage with multiple devices. The agreement is with the OEM or system builder who outlines use rights in the OEM license terms. Online or cloud services are hosted solutions. They offer a good value with point-and-click technology for easy deployment and secure anywhere access to tools. Licensing is easy to manage, and online services offer a wide range of products and services. Microsoft delivers a comprehensive set of cloud services and enterprise applications for user productivity, customer management, communication services, and customer business applications. These products are delivered as a subscription service hosted by Microsoft through your Microsoft partner of record or through syndication partners. Microsoft Volume Licensing provides simplified license and software asset management, requires only five licenses to start, and provides downgrade rights and certain re-imaging rights. This is an agreement with Microsoft, and use rights are outlined in the product use rights, or PER. Now, Microsoft's licensing offers flexibility, manageability, and the best value for your volume licensing needs. With volume licensing, customers can embrace new user work styles and infrastructure deployment choices while managing purchasing and licensing compliance is manageable. And volume licensing provides the best value for customers while protecting their existing IT investment. For organizations requiring at least 5 software licenses, Microsoft offers volume licensing programs that provide pricing advantages with predictable cost options based on your company's needs, as well as volume discounts, and enterprise-grade solutions with access to software assurance and a range of benefits, including rights to new product versions, support, training for both IT users and tools, and planning services to support Microsoft software and cloud services. While volume licensing, customers also have the greatest flexibility with a range of offerings based on the size and type of business, ownership of software, and the ability to add or include certain online services. Standardization, whereby customers receive a savings by deploying standard sets of products across the organization. And Microsoft Payment Solutions offer a convenient, flexible option to structure your technology spend for your volume licensing purchases to help improve your cash flow by spreading payments to the available budget for your organization. With Payment Solution, Microsoft covers 100% of the sales price for software, services, and hardware, including non-Microsoft products, which can potentially make it easier for customers to upgrade their technology and migrate to the cloud. Payment solutions are designed to help your company acquire the technology you need when you need it. Software assurance benefits help IT staff efficiently implement and manage Microsoft products with access to up-to-date software and new product versions as they become available, and with planning and deployment services, TechNet benefits, and access to 24/7 business-critical support to help quickly resolve issues. SA benefits, extended use rights, can also help improve the user's productivity with online training and home use licenses, while license mobility provides flexibility to deploy certain server licenses on-premises or in the cloud. SA benefits also provide technology benefits with rights to Windows 8 Enterprise, the ability to purchase higher value licenses through step-up licenses, and access to the Microsoft Desktop Optimization Pack subscription, better known as MDOP, which provides a suite of technology that helps enterprise customers take advantage of desktop virtualization, better manage Windows devices, and deliver advanced system restore capabilities. And customers with SA can choose to spread the cost of purchases across 3 equal annual sums. Now let's take a closer look at the volume licensing agreements available from Microsoft. There are certain differentiating factors to consider when selecting a volume licensing program. Agreements are available to customers based on their organization's size and can vary in length and structure, while some agreements require that all qualified devices be licensed organization-wide to participate in the particular program. Software assurance is included with some agreements and is optional with others. Also, some agreements include the ability to easily add cloud services and the ability to acquire perpetual or non-perpetual licenses, and they may also differ by available payment options, initial order, and price level requirements. Microsoft volume licensing commercial programs align 2 main categories based on the size of the organization programs for customers with fewer than 250 desktop PCs and programs for companies with more than 250 devices or users. For smaller organizations with up to 250 devices or users, the Microsoft Open Programs offers flexible, low entry requirements. For larger organizations with 250 or more devices or users, Microsoft offers the Microsoft Enterprise Agreement and Select Plus. These programs offer perpetual licenses with rights to use the software for as long as you wish once you have purchased and paid for the license, and non-perpetual licenses, which are more commonly associated with subscription programs. A non-perpetual license grants you the right to use the software for as long as you maintain your subscription. Certain programs require that all PCs be covered by a desktop enrollment, which we'll look at in detail further ahead. and software assurance, also called SA, is included in all programs except in Open License and Select Plus, where it is available as an option. Let's begin by first reviewing licensing programs for organizations with 5 to 250 PCs. Open programs are available in a variety of options to meet customers' needs. Open License is ideal for organizations that want a minimum initial purchase of 5 software licenses with the option to purchase software assurance. This program is also for a growing organization changing business needs because it is a pay-as-you-go option. For customers purchasing larger volumes of Microsoft software licenses that prefer the ability to pay as you go, Open License offers a 2-year term and provides a deeper per-unit discount, which can result in significant savings when larger quantities are purchased. Open Value is available for both organization-wide and non-organization-wide. Open Value is a 3-year agreement and includes software assurance. The organization-wide offer is recommended for commercial and government entities and includes an organization-wide commitment that lets customers spread payments annually over 3 years for the right to run the same version of a licensed product organization-wide and to upgrade to the latest versions as they are released. Open Value Subscription Option is a 3-year agreement that provides the lowest upfront costs of the open programs, the flexibility to adjust your licensing investment as your business needs change, and price protection throughout the length of the agreement, allowing for predictable budgeting. This non-perpetual license grants you the right to run the software throughout your organization as long as you maintain your subscription. In summary, the open programs are optimal for organizations that want to generally receive a pricing advantage over retail, simplify their license management through a one-stop web page to manage all of their licensing needs for simpler asset management. It's also ideal for customers who want to standardize their IT infrastructure and maximize their investment with software assurance with the ability to upgrade at any time without the need to track versions or open new agreements. It's also good for customers who would prefer to maintain a relationship with a local reseller through whom they can transact all of their licensing needs. Now let's look at licensing programs for mid-size to large organizations with a minimum of 250 PCs, users, or devices. With the Select Plus, a non-expiring agreement, organizations can maximize their return on their IT investment with the optional purchase of software assurance, which gives the full prorated value of benefit coverage, regardless of the timing of purchase. Customers also have the flexibility to spread annual payments, to receive perpetual licenses, and can purchase licenses as needed. Select Plus is a good option for mid-size and large organizations with 250 or more desktop PCs that have multiple affiliates but want to license software and services at any business unit level while still getting the price savings advantages of being a single organization. Select Plus offers a non-expiring agreement and the flexibility to acquire licenses as needed by department and offers the ability for customers to manage assets more easily and visibly across the entire organization and centralized and affiliate level reporting. Customers also have good value out of licensing and automatic price savings for purchases across the entire organization while having a single organization-wide agreement that helps streamline the contract process. The enterprise programs for mid-size and large organizations with 250 or more desktop PCs offer a 3-year enrollment term. The EA provides perpetual licenses and the ability to purchase licenses as needed. Software assurance is included in an organization-wide commitment to the enterprise desktop enrollment is required. Annual payments are standard, and an annual reconciliation process called true-up is required so organizations are able to add devices or users and then account for any devices or users that were added in the period since the last anniversary. Enterprise subscription is for organizations that prefer to subscribe to rather than purchase Microsoft products and provides an initial cost based on a 3-year subscription with the ability to increase or decrease subscription counts on an annual basis. This option may be suitable for customers that expect significant fluctuation in workforce size and IT requirements. Enterprise subscription offers full software assurance benefits. The enterprise programs provide the best overall pricing based on an organization's size, comprehensive software assurance benefits, standardized IT, as well as simplified licensing management via an organization-wide agreement. And the enterprise agreement provides a seamless way to license both on-premises software and cloud services through a single agreement, with the flexibility to choose services for different user types, to optimize technology spend to fit IT and user needs, and to streamline asset management across all Microsoft purchases. The enterprise agreement also provides access to the new server and cloud enrollment, a new licensing vehicle under the EA only that enables customers to standardize on one or more Microsoft server and cloud technologies to receive our best pricing, terms, and benefits. Now let's take a closer look at the new SCE. The enterprise agreement provides additional benefits such as cost-effective ways to optimize your organization's IT budget, flexibility to address users' needs for both on-premises and cloud services, and manageability to streamline software compliance and license management. The Enterprise Subscription Agreement, or EAS, is for customers who prefer to subscribe to rights to use Microsoft products and services. The EAS provides a cost-effective option which allows customers to lower their initial cost. The flexibility to increase or decrease subscription quantities annually to account for fluctuations in the workforce and easy manageability of subscription licenses. With EAS, customers subscribe to licenses, and when the subscription ends, so do their use rights. Now let's take a look at enrollments under the enterprise agreement. Microsoft has simplified the enrollment landscape under the EA to support the cloud OS. Previously under the EA, customers could take advantage of 3 enrollments beyond their enterprise-wide desktop commitment: the enrollment for application platform, the enrollment for core infrastructure, and the enrollment for Windows Azure. As a quick recap, the enterprise enrollment, where customers make install base-wide commitments to Windows Client, Office, the CoreCal, or ECal, in return for benefits which include a discounted price for each license with software assurance and for software assurance SKUs. The enrollment for application platform, or EAP, allowed customers to make a commitment to SQL Server and or developer tools, for example, in exchange for new use rights of licenses and SA. Those discounts were different for standard products and for premium products. The enrollment for Core Infrastructure, or ECI, for a commitment to 25 licenses offered access to Windows Server plus System Center through a SKU called the Core Infrastructure Suite and provided a discount over the cost of standalones, both for new units and for software assurance. Enrollment for Windows Azure, or EWA, was a vehicle for customers to gain access to the enterprise portal and include Windows Azure in their EA. The previous landscape had varying terms, varying conditions, and varying commitment requirements. In comparison, the new landscape is simplified with the server and cloud enrollment, which replaces the EAP, the ECI, and the EWA, creating a much more streamlined and simplified set of options for customers. As we move to the server and cloud enrollment, we're going to offer our customers the option to make install base-wide commitments to core products that exist within the SCE in return for a series of benefits. For customers that have been buying Windows Server and System Center through ECI and not making install base-wide commitments, we now have those core infrastructure suite SKUs available in our other programs, in Select, in the Enterprise Agreement as additional products. And that SKU is a great SKU for customers to take advantage of when they're buying transactionally. Purchasing through enrollments provide a cost-effective way to license Microsoft solution to meet organizational objectives. Enrollment agreement structure allows for the easy addition of new products, services, and licensing options to better support future licensing and deployment scenarios. The enterprise enrollment is for device operating systems and end user productivity. For example, Windows, Office Pro Plus, Office 365, and Cal Suites. The server and cloud enrollment is for on-premises cloud and hybrid environments and is the preferred vehicle for acquiring Windows Azure. The enterprise enrollment helps customers equip devices and users with on-premises or cloud-based versions of Microsoft desktop products. Customers receive attractive volume pricing for Microsoft core PCs and device products and deploy additional products as needed and account for these annually through the true-up process. Additionally, customers can add cloud services at their own pace when it suits their particular needs. The server and cloud enrollment is a new licensing vehicle under the Microsoft Enterprise Agreement that enables customers to standardize on one or more Microsoft server and cloud technologies and provides significant advantages. The SCE is a fully cloud-enabled licensing vehicle that gives customers the best license management and most flexibility to manage your own data centers and move to the cloud. SCE is a great licensing vehicle for standardization on Microsoft platform technologies and provides customers with our best pricing, terms, and benefits. SCE offers our lowest Windows Azure pricing, application license mobility to the cloud, and new benefits for using System Center to manage Windows Azure resources. SCE also includes a new subscription-based option which offers more flexibility when retiring workloads, consolidating, or migrating to the cloud. Customers can take advantage of simplified licensing through a standardized set of SKUs and can gain access to the latest technologies and benefits for all deployments. SCE offers Microsoft's best pricing and benefits for server and cloud products, including discounts on new licenses, software assurance, and Windows Azure as well. Eligible customers may also qualify for premium benefits like unlimited support. Now, SCE is a 3-year commitment under an EA. In addition to SCE benefits, customers can also receive EA benefits such as volume discounts. While a server and cloud enrollment can be started at any time, the SCE is available as a renewal for existing EAP and ECI customers. For customers with an expiring EA or SA commitment, it is a great time to evaluate whether SCE is the right licensing vehicle for your server and cloud needs. To enroll in an SCE, an installation-based wide commitment is required to one or more of the 4 SCE components. That's 1, the core infrastructure, 2, application platform, 3, developer platform, or 4, Windows Azure. Choose any of these components individually or group them as needed. When choosing any of the first 3 components, Windows Azure at the best pricing is also available. This means committing to full software assurance coverage across the installed base of an SCE component. In the case of System Center, a commitment is required to full System Center coverage on the Windows Server installed base through the core infrastructure suites. In return for making this commitment, the SCE offers a range of benefits, including new cloud-optimized licensing options, simplified license management, and the best pricing and terms. Minimum quantities apply for CIS SKUs for entire Windows install base. Existing deployments without software assurance are added as subscription or at the LNSA at signing. SCE is an evolution of the EAP. There are a few changes, and customers should review the EAP agreements in SCE. They will experience continuity in many respects, but will also gain positive new benefits, including the ability to easily start using Windows Azure, flexibility to retire workloads at any time with the new subscription option, and easier to understand standardized discounts. There will be more changes for ECI customers, and SCE will not be a good fit for all. The primary change is that customers will be required to make an installation-based wide commitment to CIS, which was not required with ECI. In exchange, customers get all the new SCE benefits. Microsoft Software Assurance for Volume Licensing includes services and tools to help you improve workforce productivity, streamline deployments, and capture greater value from your Microsoft software. While we have looked at the benefits of SA, let's look at the timing of purchasing SA on Microsoft software licenses. Customers with perpetual licenses but without SA may continue to use the licenses for the version they purchased forever once the agreement ends. Customers with perpetual licenses with SA at the end of their agreement may renew SA only and continue to receive the full benefits of SA, which includes access to new versions of the product without additional cost. Now let's look at the different ways to purchase Office 365 through Microsoft volume licensing agreements. Now, Office 365 brings together cloud versions of Microsoft's most trusted communications and collaboration products with the latest version of our desktop suite for businesses of all sizes. With Office 365, you have access to world-class tools and secure anywhere access in a scalable, per-user licensing model, which is ideal for anytime, anywhere access from multiple devices. Deployment concerns are alleviated as the services are hosted by Microsoft and delivered where and when you need them using Link Online, SharePoint Online, and Exchange Online. And customers with Office 2010 installed on their computers can quickly configure their software to work with Office 365. And Office 365 is also compatible with Office 2007 and newer editions of Office, and select Office 365 plans include Office Professional Plus. So when you are ready to move some or all of your computing capacities to the cloud, the Enterprise Agreement provides the means to do so easily in a single agreement in a convenient user-based offer, so your move to the cloud services occurs when it makes sense for your organization. The EA provides the flexibility to adjust the volume and mix of online services to meet fluctuations in your workforce and to match workloads of different types of users to fully use the capabilities of the Microsoft cloud services. And should you want to provision employees such as shift workers or retail workers, who may not currently have access to productivity tools, kiosk worker plans or K plans are available through Office 365 cloud services. The Enterprise Agreement provides two ways for customers to easily acquire Office 365 cloud services with the existing Enterprise Agreement through Office 365 transitions and now through Office 365 add-ons. These provide Enterprise Agreement customers with a simple, low-cost way to add Office 365 services to their existing agreements at any time during the agreement term and still maintain the integrity of the Enterprise Agreement and all of their SA benefits. What this means is that EA customers can now move back and forth between the cloud and on-premises office with less effort than ever before. Microsoft is making the move to the cloud easy, attractively priced, and flexible. Now there is a programmatic way for enterprise agreement customers to easily add Office 365 services at any time during their agreement for any number of users or workloads through the Office 365 add-on. The customer's EA does not change, and SA benefits are retained, including the right to new versions of software. Pricing reflects customers' previous investment in on-premises products, making the offer very attractive. And customers retain their EA discounts for their on-premises products, as well as volume discounts for online services. All in all, the Office 365 add-on is a simple, low-cost way for enterprise agreement customers to add Office 365 cloud services to their existing agreements and preserve intact their software assurance benefits. Microsoft volume licensing customers can now add cloud-based Office 365 to open license, open value, and open value subscription agreements. This offer is available to existing commercial and government open value and open value subscription customers with an organization-wide commitment. The Office 365 open value offer provides a discounted price to these customers. Now let's take a look at Microsoft payment solutions. Microsoft offers a range of flexible payment options which are helpful to customers who are either structuring their new SCE agreement or renewing. Depending on specific needs, customers can take full advantage of Microsoft payment solutions in a number of ways to manage their cash flow more strategically and alleviate the need of making a large upfront annual investment. Microsoft payment solutions offer deferred payments for up to 6 months. So if you are interested in SCE today, but do not have adequate funds left in this year's budget, you can defer payment until the next fiscal year when more funds are available. You get the technology you need today, even if you're unable to fully fund it in the current fiscal year. SCE requires that 3 equal payments be made each year, but this may not align well in your investment and cash flow needs. With Microsoft payment options, you can ramp payments over the term of the SCE, paying, for example, 10% of the entire 3-year SCE investment in year 1 when funds are needed for other projects, 30% in year 2, and 60% in year 3 when more funds are available. Alternatively, customers may wish to avoid having to make a large upfront payment each year and would rather utilize cash as it becomes available each month. With Microsoft Payment Solution, customers can spread their annual payments into equal monthly payments over the term of the SCE. Now let's review a few customer scenarios. A customer with over 250 PCs would like software assurance coverage and the ability to standardize on the Microsoft Core Infrastructure platform organization-wide. Which Microsoft volume licensing program best fits this customer's scenario? Solution: the server and cloud enrollment under the enterprise agreement. A customer with 75 PCs is interested in Microsoft volume licensing pricing advantage and wants to purchase perpetual licenses with software assurance while maintaining the flexibility to purchase licenses as needed. Which Microsoft volume licensing program provides the best option for this customer's needs? Solution: open or open value. A customer needs flexibility to acquire licenses as needed by department with a non-expiring agreement. Which Microsoft volume licensing program best fits this customer's scenario? Solution: the Select Plus program provides the purchasing flexibility needed by the customer and provides a non-expiring agreement. A customer with 35 PCs wants predictable budgeting year over year with price protection and the flexibility to increase or decrease quantities of licenses to accommodate fluctuations in their workforce. Which Microsoft volume licensing program provides the best option for this customer's needs? Solution: Open Value Subscription. A customer with over 250 PCs is interested in adding Office 365 cloud services at a later date to accommodate fluctuations in the organization's workforce. Which Microsoft volume licensing program will provide this customer with the flexibility they need to move to Office 365 after signing the agreement? Solution: The Enterprise Agreement. A customer with over 250 PCs is interested in standardizing organization-wide on the Microsoft application platform. Which Microsoft volume licensing program and licensing vehicle provides the best pricing and additional benefits for this customer? The solution: the enterprise agreement and the server and cloud enrollment. Now that you've completed the course, take the associated assessment. I want to thank you for your time and attention during this course. Thank you, and we'll see you again. Bye for now.